Nigeria. And as promised, today we're going to talk about how to apply for the U.S. spousal visa. Now, this process is a little time-consuming and drawn out, but I broke it down as well as I could, okay? So here we go. How to apply for the U.S. spousal visa. First, there's two types of U.S. spousal visas. There is the CR1 visa and there is the IR visa. One is on a condition, and that condition has to be removed after 2 years. And then there is one that is immediate relative, which is not based on a condition, and it does not have to be removed, okay? So, first thing you do before you apply for this visa, you got to make sure the United States will consider you legally married to your spouse, okay? Because in Nigeria, there's several forms of marriages, okay? The polygamy is legal in Nigeria, and it's fine. If you don't mind being in a polygamous marriage, then that's fine. But you have to understand that if your partner is legally married to their first spouse, then the United States will not consider that your spouse, okay? Second, if you get married at a local registry, like we talked about in the other video, the United States will not count that as your legal spouse either. So you have to get married at the federal registry. That's the only way they will not recognize your person as your legal spouse, okay? That's first thing. Second thing, okay? After that, your person, your U.S. citizen person, whoever's your U.S. citizen or U.S. permanent residence person, that person has to file petition form I-130. It's called petition for alien relative. Petition for an alien relative, form I-130. And the U.S. citizen, again, or the permanent resident must file this form. The applicant, which is the Nigerian spouse, cannot file this form. The filing fee for this form is $535, okay? The instructions for filing this form, it must be filed online, and the instructions for filing this form, they're on the back of the form. You can also find them online, okay? I'll list all the websites in the description box below. Residency in the United States is required to file this petition. You cannot file this petition if you are not a permanent resident of the United States. So let me give you an example, okay? So say you come here and you are a Nigerian and you come here and you're in the process of becoming a legal permanent resident, a lawful permanent resident, okay? And you meet somebody back home and you want that person to come here and join you. Okay, you cannot file for that person to come here and join you until your paperwork is complete. Okay, you have to have completed the whole permanent residency process before you can file for someone else to come here. Okay, so if you're a citizen, then if you were born here, then you can file immediately. There's no holdup for you. You just have to be a permanent resident, or you have to be a U.S. citizen, okay? After you file that form, your case will be sent, After you file that form, your person has to complete what is called an affidavit of support. And what an affidavit of support is, it's showing that you can support your person financially when they come to the United States, okay? And there are financial guidelines that you have to meet. That form is form I-864. So, someone asked me a question and said, you know, they were concerned about this part of the process because they were concerned they weren't going to make enough money. And if they didn't, could someone else file with them? And yes, someone else can file with you. So if you feel like you're not going to meet the guidelines for the financial support, then just get you it's called a co-sponsor. You know, it can be your mom, your dad, you know, sister, brother, any family member who's willing, or a friend, you know, who's willing to help you out. Okay, so after the USC gets this information, they will, and they approve the petition. They have to approve it, okay? Once they approve the petition, they'll send it to the National Visa Center. Okay, and once the National Visa Center receives it, which is the NVC, they will assign it to a number, okay? And after that, they receive it, they stamp it, they give it a number. Then the applicant, which is you, you're going to receive, the person in Nigeria, you're going to receive a notice to complete form DS-261, okay? DS-261. And what DS Form 261 is, that's where you notify the Office of USICS. I always get that mixed up. I might be saying a girl. But immigration. You notify immigration where you want to be notified, okay? And you can't change this address. So make sure you choose an address that you want to be notified, okay? So if you want to be notified at 123 Timbuktu, you got to keep that. For the whole process, you can't change it, okay? So, or if you want to have an agent, which is, agent is a person. So say you don't have an address, like say you live in Nigeria, well, you are in Nigeria, and say you're living with somebody and you don't want them to know your business, or you don't trust them, or they don't get mail like that, you can have like a church be your agent. You can have like the pastor of that church be your agent, and they can get the mail for you. So that's up to you, but those are, but you do have to choose your address, or you can choose your agent. Okay. After that, you will, but if you have an attorney, let me tell you, if you have an attorney complete all these forms for you, then you won't have the agent. You won't have that part. You won't receive this form. Your attorney will. After that, the NVC will begin what they call pre-processing, okay? During the pre-processing phase, at this point, the applicant will be provided and the petitioner with instructions on how to submit the appropriate fees, okay? So during the pre-processing phase is the point where you, the applicant, the person in Nigeria, and your person here in the United States is going to receive a notice on how to pay your fees. You're going to receive instructions on about how to submit the appropriate fees. After the fees are paid, the NVC will request that the applicant submit the necessary immigrant visa documents, okay? And these are an affidavit of support, application forms, and civil documents, okay? And let me tell you something. These are not three forms. I named three categories, but these are not three forms. We'll go into this later into the video about what these forms actually are, okay? Fees are charged for the following services, okay? So be prepared to pay. These are just a few of the fees. Be prepared to pay for Form I-130, which is $530. Form DS-260, there is no form for that. The medical examination and vaccines will vary. So the costs will vary and they can be pricey. So be prepared to pay for that. Other costs will be your transcripts, photocopy, fees for obtaining documents. And these documents are passports, police certificates, birth certificates, expense to and from your interview. Because you got to pay to go to your interview, so you got to count that in, okay? So you got to pay for that expense and also your travel to the United States, okay? So this is getting expenses. It's not just the fees for the documents, you guys. It's way more fees than that, okay? And those are just a few of the fees that I just named, okay? So check the website regularly before you file. Check the website to make sure those fees have not changed, because the fees are subject to change at any time. So make sure you check that website regularly, okay? And remember, you don't pay the fees at the NVC, and you won't pay the fees to the embassy, okay? You will not pay them at those two places. The NVC will tell you where and when to pay the appropriate fees. So to my person in Nigeria, if you get a letter or something, and they say it's the NVC and they want you to send them $500 to them, no. If they say, yeah, this is the U.S. Embassy pay, and I'm at the U.S. Embassy and you got to pay me $500 to get your appointment, no. Okay? Nobody should do that. The NVC will contact you and tell you where and when. You and your person, where and when to pay those fees. Nobody else will do that, okay? So remember we talked about that required documentation? So here we go. You're required to have a passport. That passport has to have at least 6 months left on it. And what that means is, say you have a passport and you want to travel in June. You're there in June. You got to have at least till December on that passport, okay? You have to have your affidavit of support with your sponsor or your co-sponsor, okay? You have to have an immigrant visa and alien application form that has to be completed, and that is form DS-260. You also have to have two photocopies, and these need to be 2x2, okay? Size 2x2. You also need civil documents, and these civil documents have to be original documents, you guys. So say that you were married and divorced, you will need your certified divorce decree, okay? You will need your certified birth certificate, okay? Everything has to be certified. Also, completed medical examination forms. The doctor will provide you with these forms after he completes the medical exam. He's going to give you an envelope with the completed forms in it. Make sure you take these forms to your interview, okay? Once the NVC determines that you have all the required documents, once they look through everything and they see everything is complete, the applicant's interview appointment will be scheduled by the NVC, okay? So once you get all these documents together, you'll receive something from the NVC that says your interview appointment, okay? So after that, the NVC will send your file to the embassy in Nigeria. It's going to either go to the, the NVC will send your file to the embassy or the consulate, either in Abuja or in Lagos, either place. Okay. It depends on where your person requested. It is also sent instructions. The applicant must also bring all documents to the interview like we talked about, okay? You got to bring all those documents. When you get to the interview, that's when you're going to be digitally fingerprinted, okay? So you'll get your fingerprints done at that time, okay? U.S. Embassy responses. Now, after the interview and get your fingerprints done, the embassy can respond at that time. I've known cases where they told them, yes, right then and there, you know, yes, you can, you know, your visa's been approved. Or they told them no. And if they told them no, they told them why. If there's something that, you know, that they needed to do, they told them why and they fixed it and then they got their visa. And then I've known cases where they've told them no right then and there. And then I've also known cases where they sent the person home and the person waited 2 or 3 weeks before they got their answer. And it was in a letter. It was in the form of writing. So it just depends. You know, I can't really tell you how long it will take. I can't tell you if they'll approve it then. It just depends. It just really depends. But when they do get their approval letter, because we're speaking in the positive, when they do get their approval letter, okay, it can either be a conditional residency or an immediate relative residency. Remember, we talked about that, okay? So the conditional residency is for 2 years, which means after 2 years, you and your person have to apply to have that condition removed and have that person status adjusted to a permanent resident or immediate relative. Now, immediate relative visa, your person doesn't have to do anything. They come in with permanent residency, okay? Again, to have the visa conditional residency removed, you do have to pay for that, okay? And that's 2 years and within 90 days that you have to pay for that, okay? And that form is $595, and there is an $85 biometric fee, okay? So that's pretty much it. There are certain conditions that make you ineligible for a visa. If you have ever been convicted of drug trafficking, if you've ever overstayed your visa, or if you've ever been found guilty of submitting fraudulent documents, your visa will be denied and deemed ineligible. But if that does happen, that the person interviewing you, they will give you advice. They'll give you information on how you can appeal that decision or file some type of waiver. They also warn that if you misrepresent yourself or if you submit any documents that are fraudulent, and you do this willingly and knowingly, you will be denied a visa, and that denial will be for the rest of your life. Okay, so just don't even engage in any of that. All right, so that's all I have for you guys tonight. It was nice talking to you. Stay warm if you're in Ohio or if you're in the Midwest or on the East Coast, because it is crazy out here, you guys. It's been snowing for like 2 weeks every day. We're just Eskimos over here. Okay, so I just wanted to say goodbye. And like I always say, peace and hair grease. And after a while, crocodiles. Thank you.